Hello everyone, this is Dr. Anjum Rashid. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will discuss diagnostic clues of food poisoning and foodborne diseases in children. Food poisoning or foodborne disease is defined as an illness which is caused by consumption of food or water which is contaminated with bacteria or their toxins, or with parasite, viruses or chemicals. Now, etiology of food poisoning or the foodborne diseases can be identified on the basis of incubation period and the specific characteristics of the illness. Incubation period is the interval between the suspected food and the onset of illness. I will discuss four groups. First is the short incubation period, that is within 1 day or usually less than 16 hours. In this first category is the chemical causes, which have ultra short incubation period. There is nausea, vomiting and cramps which occur 1 to 2 hours in poisoning due to fish associated toxins, which is usually scombrite or ciguatera. Other causes are shellfish associated toxins, monosodium glutamate or mushrooms. Now the toxic agent in the shellfish related and the ciguatera related disease is derived from the dinoflagellate unicellular organism which is present in these fish or shellfish. However, the neurological systems can present weeks later. And also Amanita mushrooms, they can lead to hepatorenal failure. Second category in the short incubation period is the bacterial causes. First is those bacteria which produce emetic syndrome, and the incubation period is usually 1 to 6 hours. In this, important bacteria are the Staphylococcus aureus. It produces nausea and vomiting due to the preformed enterotoxin A to E. Second is the Bacillus cereus. It is a spore-forming rod which is present in raw rice grains. And the emetic toxin is a preformed heat-stable toxin which is produced upon germination of the spores. Now the second group of bacterial causes in the short incubation period diseases is those bacteria which produce a diarrheal syndrome, and the incubation period is usually 8 to 16 hours. Now in this group again is the Bacillus cereus. Now this time it produces a diarrheal toxin. It is a heat labile toxin which is formed after sporulation. Second bacteria is the Clostridium perfringens type A. It produces diarrhea and abdominal cramps which occur within 1 day of ingestion of cooked meat stored at 15 to 60 degrees centigrade. And slow cooling allow these heat activated spores to germinate and elaborate enterotoxins. Now the second group of food poisoning and foodborne diseases is the intermediate incubation period, that is 1 to 3 days. In this first category is the diarrheal disease due to large bowel enteritis. In this, fever, constitutional symptoms, dysentery, bloody stools with mucus, abdominal cramps or tenesmus are typical. In this first organism is the Campylobacter jejuni. In this, vomiting is uncommon and the illness is short and self-limiting. Now, second important organism producing diarrheal disease due to large bowel enteritis and having intermediate incubation period is the Shigella species. Shigella causes prototypical diarrheal syndrome with blood, mucus and pain, and this is called the bacillary dysentery. Now tenesmus and small volume stools are typical. Toxemia may be severe and occasionally seizures may be present, especially in children. Now third organism in this category of large bowel enteritis is enteroinvasive E. coli. It causes a febrile dysentery that resembles shigellosis. Now fourth important organism in this category of large bowel enteritis is the Salmonella species, especially the non-typhoidal salmonellosis. It is a zoonotic infection which is acquired from bovine or poultry reservoirs. Illness range from mild non-bloody diarrhea to severe dysenteric illness. Now fifth one is the Salmonella typhi, which causes enteric or the typhoid fever. It is a systemic toxic illness. Now Salmonella typhi has an exclusively human reservoir, and it is acquired either via ingestion of a large inoculum in food or contaminated water or from personal contact with a carrier. Now, another organism which produces diarrheal disease due to large bowel enteritis in this intermediate incubation period group is Vibrio parahemolyticus. In this, diarrhea is profuse and watery, and the blood is not commonly present in the stools. Now, the diarrheal disease is due to small bowel enteritis, which have intermediate incubation period of 1 to 3 days. In this, first important organism is the enterotoxigenic E. coli. It is the most common cause of traveler's diarrhea. Diagnosis is usually clinical. Fever and bloody stools are typically absent. Second important organism is the Vibrio cholera. Cholera is common in endemic areas and during epidemics. It produces profuse watery diarrhea and vomiting and can lead to dehydration and prostration. Some viruses also produce diarrheal disease due to small bowel enteritis. These include Norwalk-like virus, rotavirus, adenovirus, estrovirus, or Calici virus. These produce vomiting and headache, and there may be diarrhea and low-grade fever. Botulism is also included in the intermediate incubation period group. Nausea, vomiting, skeletal muscle paralysis, and autonomic symptoms occur within 18 to 36 hours of ingestion of food which contain Clostridium botulinum. Now, disease is mediated by the preformed toxin in older children and adults, but it may follow ingestion of spores in infants. Now, third group of food poisoning and foodborne disease is long incubation period, that is 3 to 5 days. Now, the important organism is the enterohemorrhagic E. coli. It causes hemorrhagic colitis with a 15% risk of progression to hemolytic uremic syndrome, especially in children. And this is due to cytotoxin, virotoxin, or Shiga-like toxin. Now, E. coli O157H7 is one of such E. coli that reside in the gut of cattle. Mild abdominal pain, malaise, transient fever are followed by watery diarrhea. Bloody stools and more severe abdominal pain ensue several days later. Paucity of fever is a diagnostic clue in this condition. Second important organism in long incubation period is Yersinia enterocolitica. It produces a febrile illness with abdominal pain due to mesenteric lymphadenitis. Diarrhea is not prominent, and illness mimics appendicitis. Illness may be prolonged, lasting 2 to 3 weeks. In infants, a diarrheal illness is more common with occasional septicemia, and diagnosis is made with blood and stool culture. Now, fourth group of foodborne diseases is very long incubation period, that is 1 to 4 weeks. In this, parasitic infections include giardiasis. It is a spectrum of illness which range from asymptomatic carrier state to acute watery diarrhea, but a subacute intermittent diarrheal illness is also common. Second foodborne disease due to parasitic infection in this very long incubation period group is amoebiasis. It is caused by Entamoeba histolytica, which is a protozoan that causes dysentery and extra-intestinal manifestation, especially the hepatic abscess. Third parasitic illness is the cryptosporidiosis, which is caused by a Cryptosporidium parvum. It causes a diarrheal illness with fever and abdominal pain. Now, foodborne bacterial disease in this very long incubation period group include brucellosis. It is caused by Brucella melitensis. It is a febrile illness, and the food source is raw or unpasteurized milk or cheese, most commonly from the goats. Now, viral causes in this group include hepatitis A virus. Its incubation period is 15 to 50 days, and it causes viral hepatitis, which is transmitted by a fecal-oral route. Now, protozoal illness, which has very long incubation period, is the toxoplasmosis. It results from ingestion of undercooked meat. It is a non-specific illness with systemic symptoms and generalized lymphadenopathy, which occur in healthy individual. Or there may be an asymptomatic infection. Now, persons who are immunocompromised, they can develop severe CNS infection. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel.